Welcome to NAB 2024. It's a brand new year with a lot of new products to talk about from the likes of Blackmagic and ARRI and so many more. But right now, we're gonna talk about some new live production equipment. All right, first off that we're gonna talk about today is Birddog and their X-Series cameras, the X1 and X1 Ultra. Birddog's X-Series cameras are capable of NDI HX3 over Wi-Fi are their first cameras to include tracking natively in the camera without requiring firmware upgrades and feature an e-ink display on the side. I can really see these cameras being extremely popular amongst people that need to break down and set up quickly. The fact that you don't have to rely on routing Ethernet cable to a router that all of these cameras are centrally connected to, and trust that as long as you have a strong wireless router, you can get the video exactly where you need it to be. What's really an impressive upgrade, however, is that it's able to track subjects through the camera natively without requiring any additional software. With just a web browser, you can select a subject and track them wherever they go. Both cameras use Sony 1/2.8-inch sensors, but the X1 features a 20x optical zoom and only up to 1080p60 recording. The X1 Ultra has a 12x optical zoom, but is capable of up to 4K 30p recording. One of the interesting things about this camera is this new e-ink display. Now, at first, it comes across like an odd choice, right? Their previous cameras normally had OLED displays that, you know, displayed the information that you really needed to know. But with this e-ink display, what's really interesting is that it gives them more flexibility for branding opportunities. Like right now, you can see that there's a QR code, which makes it really easy to just scan it and get into the back end of the camera and control it. But any company could use it to put their logo, for example. It also has a very low brightness, so it means that you can have access to all of that information without adding light to your environment. So it's not going to be distracting if you have it in a dark room, for example. All right, so we're here at ARRI's booth checking out their new Alexa 35 with LPS1 system. The LPS1 or Live Production System 1 is an attachment for the Alexa 35 that empowers it to work in broadcast scenarios. At initial rollout, ARRI's gonna sell the Alexa 35 with the LPS1 in a few packages to make sure that you have everything you need to get up and running. But eventually, they'll sell the LPS1 separately so that you can attach it to existing Alexa 35 systems. It really feels like they threw everything in the kitchen sink at the LPS1 system. It can handle everything from 4K 60p to redundant 2120 IP outputs, and it even features fiber optic connections for connecting multiple cameras together. So it seems that ARRI is really aiming to bring that Hollywood magic that you get from the Alexa 35 to the high end of broadcast systems. Right now we're back at the B&H booth testing out one of the more entry-level products in the video production space, the Logitech MEVO Core. Now, despite being entry-level, this camera is surprisingly capable. Not only is it a wireless Micro Four Thirds interchangeable streaming camera, but it's also NDI capable. You can actually feed NDI sources into this camera's ecosystem and you'll be able to live switch between them. It's also capable of panning and scanning around the frame, cutting between multiple angles within the frame, and that's because this is a 4K streaming camera. MEVO's system also allows for multicasting, meaning you can stream to YouTube, Facebook, TikTok, and more all at the same time. At the booth behind me, Sony has also announced a brand new PTZ camera, the BRC-AM7. The new BRC-AM7 camera has a 1-inch sensor with 20x optical zoom, is capable of 4K 60p output, and is even able to record 4K 120p internally. The camera's real claim to fame, however, is their AI PTZ auto-framing technology that's built into the camera. This will allow users to not only track subjects, but also control how they're framed. You can set how wide the frame is, how much headroom there is, and what position they are in the frame as well. Sony's calling this a new flagship model for their broadcast quality PTZ cameras. And as such, it's capable of matching any of their cinema cameras as well. It has S-Cinetone, S-Log 3, ITU 709, really just about anything you need to match with Sony's other broadcast and cinema level cameras. The BRC-AM7 seems like it's gonna be a great option for houses of worship, event halls, and educational institutions that use a mix of cameras between broadcast, cinema, and PTZ to deliver high quality video. Last but certainly not least is Blackmagic, who released a ton of new products at the show today. But right now, we're gonna focus on their IP2110 products. For those of you that are unfamiliar, SMPTE2110 is a new standard from the Society of Motion Picture and Television Engineers. It controls how video, audio, and metadata are sent across networks. What this means for Blackmagic products is that it creates new ways for them to send video from their cameras and media recorders to their production switchers, monitors, and audience. In other news, Blackmagic also released new production switchers and a new microcontroller. What's kind of cool about this A10 micro panel is that it's able to work wirelessly. Look, Ma, no cables. All in all, Blackmagic has released a ton of new products to help production crews really make their workflows super efficient. Whether you are completely IP-based or some kind of hybrid in between, Blackmagic has great solutions for you. And that's just the start of the product announcing right here today at NAB 2024. There's tons of new hardware and software and even firmware all launching today. But you tell us, what are you most excited for? Let us know in the comments below. I'm Jabari with B&H. Have a spectacular day.